gentlemen, I am the King Cam Blackman, and welcome to the very first mini-series of King's Carnival Cade, known as Monday Coin Cade. I'm being joined here with the former player of the first King's Carnival Cade, Jose. Jose is back in action. And today I'm being joined by
Phil Bullmaster,
who is a first for King's Carnival Cade altogether. How do you guys feel about being a part of the first episode of Monday Coin Cade?
I'm excited. I appreciate the invite. I've watched the first episode of King's Carnival Cade and big fan of it. So looking forward to seeing what we can do.
All right, for sure. And thank you very much, Phil, for that. And Jose, no stranger to the first King's Carnival Cade. How do you feel about being a part of the first mini series?
It was pretty fun, you know. But you know, it's pretty fun to play arcade games, go up against, compete against. But I want to.
Not sure how to get the words out?
Yeah, I'm not sure how to get the words out.
It's because this time around, we're going to be growing the series a little bit more instead of just having one full episode. We're going to start doing this a little bit bi-weekly or weekly. We'll see how we do. We're going to start having these every other Monday, so stick around in the long haul. But here's how it's going to work. Pretty much like the normal show, you guys go head-to-head in one game, and only one game, and that game today is Fixate. That is our game for today. So, it'll work as best out of two. Both of you guys will play head-to-head, one player at a time, one coin. Game first, game over, so your scores, we'll keep track of your score. And we will see who comes out on top. Best to two, high scores, 2 points. High score gets a point, low score does not get a point. Simple enough, guys? All right, and now I think, who said we're going first? Jose, you're gonna go first? All right, well, good luck. Yeah, handshake it out first, very good. All right, now let's take a look over at Fixate really quick. Fixate is, of course, the game. A pretty simple vertical game. It's like a shoot 'em up vertical kind of, but not really.
Yeah, it's from Toaplan, the creators of Truxton and Zero Wing.
And Zero Wing, yes. Know anything about do you know anything about Fixate, boys?
I do. So this is actually the sequel to OutZone. I've watched playthroughs online. I got to play it when it was a Monday mystery game when it came out that night. I'm a big fan of this game and a big fan of this genre as well.
It's a very fun game, and I think a lot of people are very familiar with it, and I was glad to pick this one for the first game. So we're going to see how both of you guys do. All right, Jose, without any further ado, I'm going to step over here. Step on up, kind sir. I'm going to get this ready to go here. We're going to call it out as we go. Let's get your coin in. All right, we're recording and ready to go. Get your, he's got his coin in. And there he goes, right then and there. Let's see who he picks. I think he picked the GX. All right, rocking and rolling, and there he goes. So again, there's a lot of opportunities for points in this one. Using weapons, changing weapons. Don't forget about your changing panel. Changing the panel as we go. Sorry about this, folks. Keep passing a bag along. Stay with me. I hope. Are we still good? Okay, we're still good. In the meantime, as I was saying, Jose is just keep casualing along. So you notice how he's, again, changing weapons every so often. Something you want to keep track of as you go. Grabbing those power-ups and those statues, 5,000 apiece. Oh, he went down a little bit. But he's all right. Now he's got to speed up. And casually but surely. All right. Staying on one side, want to make sure those robots are out of his way. Ah. Just hang in there. All right. Halfway there to that boss fight. Slowly but surely. He's got to hurry up because eventually at a certain point some enemies are going to start coming out and locking on to him. If he doesn't, but he's got the right idea. All right, yep, oh, here they come. There's a warning sign. Oh, here they come. There's those orbs. Oh, yes, but it blew him up, though. He was taking some of them out, though, with his power-ups, which was smart, but eventually they just caught up right with him, and sadly, yeah, that very unfortunate. 80,000. Oh, man, 80,000. All right, so Jose, we're going to say, I think it was 80,000. I think it was like 87,000, I believe I was seeing that. Let's see if we get an initial here. So we have 87,220. Good job by Jose. We'll see how that holds out in just a good moment, kind sir. Thank you for that. Bullmaster.
Tough competition.
I know, right? How do you think you're going to do? It's a little
well,
decent.
I have to go with the Mike Tyson look-alike.
Mike Tyson look-alike?
Tyson.
All right, man. Let's see how you do. 87. That is Jose's high score. Bullmaster needs to get over maybe just about 88 to get there. Oh, there he is. Cole Hara? I think that's the name I saw. The first word was Cull. I think that was the first one I saw. But let's see how he does. Oh, yeah, I see what he means. He's got that spread, changing the panel. Hard?
Yeah, short distance, but...
Short distance.
Powerful, but short.
Powerful, but short. That's what I was saying. Maybe up to par. I'm grabbing those points. Remember, 90,000 or 88,000 is the number. And taking advantage, dodging those projectiles. Slightly but sure. Oh, using that bomb. Oh no, I think he got stuck.
You're right.
I think he got stuck, or something went wrong right there. Oh. Oh, man. That's okay. I think he's going to be able to recover using that spread. Very nice. Nice bomb. And slowly hanging in there. Ooh. All right. Up to 70,000 almost. There it is. Yep, 70,000. All right, he's ahead of Jose. Got 90, almost to 100,000. All right, he's on that boss fight. Now, this one, there's about three bosses to take out. So he's going to have to use, I think, a lot of spread here. And he's definitely doing it right now. He took out one. Oh, there he is. He got them both. 127,830. Nice job by Bullmaster. Good stuff. But he's not done yet. Now, he does have the lead, but, you know, again, Jose can still catch up with another chance. So, you know, it's not over yet. But it looks like definitely for sure the first point will be going to Bullmaster for sure. But let's see how he does. He's going to keep it going. We'll see how far he gets. He's on stage two right now. Yeah, there we go. I think he was using a bomb right there to clear out that that millipede-looking enemy, or whatever that was. There's another one. All right, 179, almost to 200. Just about catching up. There's another millipede. Oh, just blew it up. Good stuff. There's another one. Oh, you got it. There we go. Oh, but he went down. 100 and I think, what was that number? 100?
201.
We made it to a, I think he got a 201. Let's see what we got. We'll get that score in just a minute. 201,170. Bullmaster gets the first point of this first round. Congratulations, Bullmaster. Good game. But we are not done yet. You guys know it as well as I do. It's first to 2 points, so we're not done yet. So, and again, we're going to do another one. So, Jose, you ready to come back up to work?
Sure.
All right, Jose, step on up once again, my man. Let's see how you do for your round two. Now, even though Bullmaster got the first point, even though Bullmaster did get the first point, Jose was, you know, watching Bullmaster play. So, you know, anything can happen, you know, when there's people over your shoulder spectating.
He's a tough opponent. He won the your other show that one time, so... Yeah, anything can happen. We'll see. Hey. Tough to hold on to this one.
A lot of unpredictability can happen on these games, and that's the one thing I love about, you know, stuff like this, is because, again, anything can happen. You know, when you got somebody who's good, there's always somebody who's watching and spectating the skills. So, you know, it's always a matter of anything can and will happen. All right, now, let's get back on over to Jose. So, once again, it's using that same strategy, because the best thing about getting... The best thing about replaying the game again is that, you know, they get the chance to come back. So it's very, very vital and very, very important. That was like watching. Oh. Very, very important that Jose is watching Bullmaster rock and roll. He's playing it safe. Using that bomb. Is he going to use another? Ooh, good dodging. Great dodging. Pause. There's bonus, there it is. Ooh, all that damage. Ooh, beautiful damage by Jose. Beautiful damage. Now here comes that first boss again. Alright, here he comes. Or here they come, as I said. There's three of them. There's not just one. There's three of them out there. Ooh, 129 for Jose. He's now with that bonus points, 137. Things looking good. From stage two. Now this is where Bullmaster was on earlier and was at that 200 mark. Let's see if Jose can remember a little something from last run as he uses those lovely special power-ups. Be careful of that big millipede. Oh, okay, he's hanging on. He's okay. Ooh, he's trying. Ooh, chill. Very nice dodging. There's another millipede. Nice. 186,500. Almost up to Hondo. Oh, Scott, it's okay. I think he's got one more. That 200,000. Whoa, beautiful. Now all those, could have got all those bombs though. I think he's on the boss. I think he might be on the boss here, or maybe the entranceway to a boss. Let's see. Oh no, I don't think so. Not yet. 214,800 or 600. Don't know if that's an 8 or a 6. Yeah, keep up. Destroying those saw blades. All right, hanging on, surely. Coming on through. Ooh, some saw blades. Oh, there's a power up right there. Just gotta get through it. There it is. Speed up. Good work. Good job. 239,000. Mind that saw blade. Oh, I think he's on the boss now. All right, here we go. Let's see what he does. Got it. Very good. Jose rocking and rolling. Love to see that. We love to see it. 309,200. Well, excuse me, 324. All right, we got some platforms out there, though. Oh, man. Not taken out, though. Ooh, he's got to be careful. Oh, 327,550. Good score by Jose. Love to see that. Man. I think you got Bullmaster thinking now, huh?
I got my work cut out.
Yep.
For me.
I think he's got him thinking. All right, Bullmaster. Jose is in the lead in this game. Will Bullmaster be able to hang on and take it back? He still has his 1 point. Jose could get the point in this game if Bullmaster beats 327. 327,000 is the number he must beat. He's going with that Mike Tyson lookalike. Then it's good luck charm all match long. All right, back to the action once again as Bullmaster is rocking and rolling. Same strategy. And then it's taking those same. See, the best part about the players going back up again is that they could take those same routes and nothing can change. So it's like exactly remembering how to know how to improve. So that's why these same gameplays are very, very, very important. Your first play, you remember everything, and then you play again for a second turn. So keep that in mind as these go on. Uh-oh, here comes those things. The spike ball. Oh! Out of nowhere, just got him out of the side. All right, he's on that first boss, casually, slowly but surely. All right. His spreading. He was moving around, though, but that's okay. He hung in there, 131,390. About 200 shy off of Jose. Oh, man, hate to see that. Oh. A little nerve-wracking. Oh,
I would say that's. I'm surprised I even managed to get to the first stage.
It's an unpredictable game with a lot of unpredictable twists and turns. So it's a matter of anything can happen. Oh, matter of anything can and will happen. So it is amazing that you did put up that 327.
Yeah.
Really good score, Jose. Really good score. All right. Bullmaster needs to scans. Ooh. Oh, man. 182. Okay, so, well, good GGs on Bullmaster for that one. I think Jose got the point for that. So, here's how this is going to go. So, that was the two games. So, that was our two games. So, I guess for the very first time, we're going to have a tiebreaker game. I didn't think this was going to happen, but it's happening. So, here's what we're going to do. We're going to take a short break, and then when we come back, we're going to do our tiebreaker game for our last point, and whoever gets the highest score in this gets the W. Are you guys ready? You guys ready to face that mystery game?
Yep. I'm ready. Ready? Yep.
Oh, you guys are going to be in for a treat for what that mystery game is. In the meantime, we're going to take a break. We'll be right back. Until then, the mystery game for the tiebreaker. All right, and we are back. So we are back with our tiebreaker game, which is going to be Warriors of Fate. So both of you guys have played mad. He's trying to get a look at it. I think he's almost there. There it is, Warriors of Fate. The marquee was shown. All right, so we both played great matches in Fix 8. We had 300,000 to 200,000 unpredictability in both games. So congratulations to the both of you two for outstanding gameplay. Great work. But now we're going to switch things up a little bit with the tiebreaker of Warriors of Fate. So how do you guys both feel about this tiebreaker? The first ever for Monday Coincade.
I'm looking forward to it. Jose's a tough competitor, so it's going to be a great challenge. And I love Capcom beat-em-up, so good choice on the game.
I think I wanted to go with something a little bit more on the beat-em-up side as well, because, you know, this game is very, very fun. I played it myself. Jose, how do you feel about going into the tiebreaker of Warriors of Fate?
Beat-em-ups are fun, but I suck at beat-em-ups for scoring.
I know, it can be a little tricky, I know, but don't worry. I'm pretty sure you're both going to do a great job. You're both going to work hard in this tiebreaker match. And remember, highest score wins, so it is anybody's game. Who would like to go up first? I think, who do we decide? Jose, you're going to go up first? You got practice on the bad boy, so go on up ahead and step on over, my friend. All right, and without any further ado, here he goes. Here goes Jose for his tiebreaker match in Warriors of Fate on the first ever King's Carnivalcade Monday Coincade. We're going to fix this camera here. All right. And there he goes. It's on the first round. Now, a little bit of fun fact for this game. It had a little bit of a screen error the first time, but then in due time it got fixed and it was able to get back on its hefty way again. So it's good to see this game back in action. All right. Now you see Jose starting on that horse. That's going to be very vital when playing this game, because you want to try to be on that horse as much as possible. It'll definitely make you balance out all the way through and through. And slicing him up. Casually but surely. Oh no, he knocked him off the horse. Uh-oh. Let's see if he can get back. He can get back on it. There you go. He's back on the horse. All right, he's lining up. Beat-em-up genre can be a little tricky sometimes. But as long as you got a momentum going, you can get as many points as you can and take out as many enemies as you like. Oh. All right, anyway, so with that said, no, I think he lost the horse. I turned, I looked away, and I think he lost the horse. I think it's gone. But that's okay, now he's on foot. Ooh, good jump. I think it's like a jump kick. There's another one. So, yeah, you see him? Yeah, I got those hooks. Get those punches in. All right. Taking it on over to the other side. Now, something to keep in mind as you play, for those watching this at home, you could get more points by picking up the food and picking up gold and treasure that is lying around in boxes and items. So, and you can also get more food and health from the enemies you beat up as you go. So definitely a lot of point opportunities everywhere. So keep that in mind as you play. Slowly but casually, surely. Oh, just got that one. I think he got it. Yeah, there he is. All right, now, yeah, he can hold the button to speed up that boss, to get to the section of the boss, that is, not speed up the boss itself. All right, and he's smashing up this. He's gonna get that food. Oh, I think, oh, no, he's good. He's good. He didn't get hit. Yeah, get through those enemies. I thought he got hit. Oh, I think it went for an elbow drop, but missed. All right, there he goes, another one. It's just throwing him over. Yeah, using that ram. He can open up that. There's a box right there. Oh, he wants to get that food. Ooh. There's a box right there. He can open that, and I think there's something inside. He can kick it, maybe? Oh, I guess not. Right, I think you gotta either kick it or throw something at it. Oh, there's some food. Ooh, let's see, I'm sliding. Oh, and the spear. I'm getting the spear in. Ah, man. Oh, get that food. Oh, just got that first boss. 97,000. 97,000? Yes. 9,700. Yes. Yes, Jose. Unleash the power. Gotta get that intensity in.
There you go.
Yeah, he's got that intensity in. All right. He's on round two. There he goes. All right. He's got three lives, so I think you get a... I think there's an extend in this game somewhere. Quick shout-outs to Andrew. Andrew was playing this earlier and was telling me some of the itty-bitty point bonuses that come around in this game. It's hard to remember them, but, you know, as time goes on, true. But shout-outs to Andrew. All right, and break those boxes open. Get that sword. Yeah, now he's got a sword in his hand. Now he can start slicing and dicing around. Oh, careful of these guys. These guys kind of sneak and charge at you if you are not careful. And they will come at you at any given time and moment, so you definitely want to be careful. Oh, just like that. I think one of them just... hang on. Let's... Wait. Oh, not yet. You'll notice when they do it, too, because they'll kind of run by you and do a little sneak move. So you'll definitely notice when it happens. Right here. Yeah, like that. That red one just did it right there. He'll just kind of run by you and charge at you, and you want to be careful when that happens. You also notice there's some weapons being thrown, so you want to be careful of those. You can hit those to project them off. So you can fight those off. Yeah, they're using those jump kicks. You can reflect the projectiles that come at your way. He's using those jump kicks. He's just using those jump kicks to get around. That blue one's still out there. I think he needs one more hit. All right, I think he's got it. No, it's still out there. Okay, there he goes. In 2 minutes, 40 seconds. In game time, that is. Oh, I think he dropped him on his head. Did he drop him on his head? I think
he... Yes, he did. He got it.
Definitely dropped him on his head. He said, Jose said he needs some energy. Now he's definitely going to need it. He had some earlier. Uh-oh. Hey, hang on, though. Ooh. This is barely with those jump kicks. Oh, well, he went down. He's got two lives left, 191,050 or so, almost a 200,000. Oh. Oh, boy. Well, you got the, 200,000. Very good. Yeah, you want, see, that's what I was talking about earlier. That's those points. You want to keep continuing to grab that as many as you can, because even if you have full health, you can get more points. You can get more points as you go along. Oh, yeah. Tossing them away. Get those books. Yeah. Book. Book, per se. It's not books. It's a book.
What is it, 50 Shades of Grey?
Jose thinks it's 50 Shades of Grey. I don't think that's what it is. I don't think it's 50 Shades of Grey. I don't think 50 Shades in Grey would be in a 1992 Capcom game. Or so I.
Or actually, it could be The Stand or It.
Or it could be It. Maybe it might be It. Maybe it could be. Who? We don't know. We don't know. It's a mystery. It's a mystery left unsaid. Now, Jose. Oh, Jose had that axe in his hand. That could have been really useful for that second boss. Oh, he's getting barricaded, though. Ooh, I think he got barricaded a little bit. It's okay. He's still got time. He's got that horse now. Yeah, so again, as I said, you want to use that. Oh, that horse knocked him off. Yeah, there goes. Get the combination in. Now, something very vital here. If you're facing the wrong way, you can't turn around. Let's see if Jose can find the way to turn around. Oh, there's some bombs that went out there. Can Jose find the way to turn around? Yeah. He can't turn around. Can he find the way to get it? Oh, just getting jumped. Oh, there's some treasure. Some points. Some points right there. Oh, a double hit off. One life left, but that boss is almost gone. Can he hang on tight? Yeah, throwing that boss is really good too. Get some damage out. Hang on tight. Solar Warrior over here making some static noises. I can barely hear him. In the meantime, he's just thinking. Oh, there he goes. He got it. 264,100 points. He's showing his intensity. He's showing his intensity. All right. Now he is up to, that's going to probably put him at 300. It should. Oh, and he got an extra life, so he's moving on still. It's going to be a big game. I think this is going to be a very interesting. Oh, so now he's on the bonus round where he has to spin the joystick and mash the button to eat the food. This is a very interesting bonus round. Probably not a great one if you have an empty stomach. Probably not. But it's... Yeah, no. Anyway, I think he got first. Did he? I think he did. Did you get first, Jose?
I don't know.
I think you did. I think there was a big bonus right there, so I think you got it. We'll check that in post. Well, I don't know. I think you got a bonus. We'll check it in post. We'll check it in post. So, all right. Round three now. Intensity kicks up here. The clock ticking down. He still has one life left.
Mace.
We get that mace. So the enemies in this game... They're very, 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 very easy to come apart. They can easily come apart in an instant. But most importantly, the animation is that they can slice and dice them apart if you're using those maces or those swords. A lot of crazy animation for a Capcom game. Picking up that book. Oh, up to 329. There's another book. There's a sword to the side. Oh, got some barrels on the way. There's that food right there. Yeah, there you go. He picked up that food. There's some barrels. Oh, he almost dodged it. Almost dodged it. He almost dodged it. That's okay, but he still got the points. Was it tough on that one?
That was funny to me.
He was trying to jump over, but I think he elbow dropped the barrels. But that's okay. I think that it didn't take too much out of him, so he's fine. All right. He's almost to the next boss fight. He's almost to the next boss fight, which is quite the... Oh, let him go. Let that gentleman go through. All right, as I was saying, he's on the next boss fight, which is maybe just about as soon as he takes out these enemies all over the place, because they keep spawning. He's going to need to... He's going to get that food. He's almost there. Just maybe a few more. Oh, maybe. A couple more. Oh, the fire and the arrows. Okay, there goes those two. He's got one on the right. There's some food. Maybe. the last? Oh, he's still got one more. One more. There you go. He got it. All right. Now he should be able to go in. Now the place is going to start getting lit up on fire. He's going to grip that fire torch. Be careful not to be in the fire, though. All right. Now he's on boss number three. It's got maybe 1.5 health bar. So there's a lot of work to do. Ooh. Oh, but he got bulldozed. Almost up to 4 Hondo. Oh, no. Oh, and the hammer swing. I hate to see it. But he's okay. Oh. Oh, he landed him on his head. Landed him on his head, but he went down. Let's see if he can recover. Yes, he throws him right into those enemies, which is good, but he's got to be careful of that one attack that he does, which is like a just comes at you like a bowling ball, a whole barrel roll at you. And you want to make sure to get out of the way when he comes through there, or even when he does that big attack to the left. Ooh, you get that, there's some gold right there. 400. See if he can have, let's see how long it, oh, get that food. Ooh. He's hopping all over the place, and you got to worry about him. You got to worry about the other guys coming at you. But that boss can charge right back at you fast if you're not looking behind you. Oh, good move. Throwing and tossing him. Let's see if he's,
no match for me.
Jose saying he will not lose to him. It is a very hard boss. Oh, there's more here. He's got more company. He's got more company. The three hit. I think we saw about 400 some up in there.
412.
412,000. So Bullmaster now has to get over. Oh, we got an initial. Hang on a second. We're going to see what this initial and see. We're going to get that number real fast. But I'm pretty sure I saw 420, I think. Did you see a 420? Yes, I know. Dumb jokes. What was our score, Jose?
412,800.
412,800. All right. Well, I don't know, Bullmaster. 400,000 is the number. How do you feel?
We'll see what happens. I'm not really confident. I'm going to do my very best, but he put up a monster score. He more than doubled his practice score. So,
man,
give it my best.
All right. Well, good luck. Step on up, my men, and get ready to go. All right. Here comes Bullmaster. Jose, you could step on over here to the right and give Bullmaster some space here. All right. So right now, Jose has the lead score. So this is still anybody's game. Let's see how Bullmaster does in his round. But, Jose, you did pretty good. How do you feel, man?
This is I would say about beat-em-ups, but I'm still trying to get used to it for scoring. So maybe when a new beat-em-up reveals on Monday Mystery Game, maybe I could get maybe third or second place.
It's always good to get some practice in, and I think you definitely showed that right then and there. So really good work. Great job. I think that third boss almost had you.
Yeah. It wasn't until the third boss.
Yeah, third boss is very intense. That's where I was when I played the game, too, for the first time. All right. Now, let's get on to Bullmaster here, who's rocking and rolling. Now,
I wonder if I can count that score for an arcade.
Maybe. I would take a picture of it and, bring it on up to the front for David to look at. We'll take a look at that later. In the meantime, okay. Now, excuse me, we're on Bullmaster now. Yeah, you see Bullmaster grabbing that food. Maybe. He's trying to grab that food. There we go. There he goes. There he goes. He got it. I think he's just now knowing the turnaround method. Yes, he is. He's definitely knowing the turnaround method. Slicing on through. Ryan. He definitely knows about that turnaround method. That is a plus. Oh. I think he's trying to turn around again. But he's still getting damage out. Got a good strategy going. Oh, okay. Well, he's got a good strategy going, which is, horse riding backwards. Very great strategy, but he's trying. Okay, there we go. Now he's facing front. So it's, again, like I explained earlier, that is a thing. So you take one hit from the backward side, you will have to find a way to reverse yourself and turn around. So it's a little tricky. Uh-oh, you got to hurry up. That's not a good sign. Let's see if he can recover. Oh boy. He'll have to somehow charge his way through. 10 seconds. Oh boy, oh no. Ooh, 3, 2. I don't know. Oh, I think he just got it. Wow, really good stuff. Uh-oh, but he's turned around the other way. Oh no. See if he can get it back in. Ooh. Those bombs being thrown. Oh. Need those treasures. Oh. Still has 3 lives. Let's see. Ooh. Just barely getting out of harm's way. Oh. But, oh no. It's taking him out of the area. Oh, but there's that slicing I was talking about. You saw almost all those body pieces came apart. Is he gonna get back on the horse? Yes, he is. Oh. Oh, it took him out. I think he just needs one more hit. There it is. Uh-oh. Oh, it's big damage. Oh, that screen's... Uh-oh. Okay. Screen's starting to flicker a tad bit. It's a little concerning. It's a little bit concerning. I hope that wasn't that screen issue that they were talking about earlier. Let's see if Bullmaster can hang on. Just got to be a little careful, that screen flickering. Oh boy, well, the screen's starting to flicker just a tad bit. Well, I think it might have stopped now. No, I think it stopped now. Oh no, it's still doing it. Let's see what happens. $200,000. It's doing good. There's some books and gold out there. There they go. He got them. He's got to watch out for the charging guys. Oh, it took him down. Still got about a couple of lives left to go. Slicing. Oh, because it knocked it out of his hand. Oh, he stopped their attacks, which is very good. So you actually can stop them too, so that also helps. All right, he's got some health. That screen's flickering. Sliced open and get those meat buns. The meat bun. Oh, he's got company. He's got company coming around the corner. Ooh. Oh, yeah. That screen is rumbling a little bit. Thank you, baby. Bullmaster's hanging in there. He's hanging in there. All right, and those points adding up. I think he's on the boss now. I think he should be. Oh. Or no, not yet. Not yet. Almost. Still plenty of time. Hanging in there, hanging. Oh, just barely. And he knocked him off the horse. Good move. Knocked him off that horse, got immediately on it. Oh no. He's trying to get that barrel that's over there. He's trying to get that barrel that's over there. He wants to burst that barrel open. Oh, and the fire. Oh. Starting to. Oh. Trying to get that barrel. I think he's trying to get there. Oh. It's no food, but he's got that axe. That axe is to open. There's some gold, too. Oh. I'm gonna throw that guy in there. There it is. He's doing good. Slicing, dicing with that axe. Trying to get out of there. Oh! Oh, he got an extra life. He got a little chance to recover there. But you see, he's still taking advantage of that opportunity by throwing and dodging. Half health left. Ooh, almost. Almost there. That's the way to do it. Just taking your time. There's some food. Screen rattling and rumbling. Oh, the enemy went into that bomb. I'm pretty sure I saw that. That enemy went right into that bomb. All right. Oh. That fire, though. Oh, man. Oh, man. Well, that was crazy. Thank you, 300,000 from Bullmaster. Wow. Craziest match ever. I think that was probably more red hot than the Fixate match. So we had a 300,000, I believe, versus 400. Well, with that said, let me get this out of here. Let me see that again. Oh, let me get that. Let me get both of the scores again one more time before we wrap it up. I want to get both of those because those are crazy games. And Bullmaster, you were. It was a little. Oh yeah, Jose's getting his pitcher in real quick. Oh, here we'll get it. It'll come back. Just don't put a coin in. But we had, I think, 300,000.
328
and 412. Guys, great game. I think with that all said and done, Jose, you are the winner. Congratulations. Great game. Bullmaster, great job as well. Thank you so much. I think with that said, that'll do it for the first small episode of King's Carnival Cade Monday Coincade. Look forward to seeing more of these on my YouTube in the coming weeks or so. It'll be great to get more of these out here at Galloping Ghost Arcade. Huge shout out to Doc Mac, of course, for letting me film these as always. Again, guys, thank you again for being a part of this, and I hope we're gonna have more of them. Thank you. Hope to have more part of them. Jose, I know as a former King's Carnival Cade contestant, we're probably gonna be seeing more of you be a part of these as well. And many more. With that said, I am the King Ken Blackman. Thank you guys all for watching. And again, shout out to Doc Mac and Galloping Ghost Arcade, the world's largest arcade in Brookfield, Illinois. And I'll see you guys in the next King's Carnival Cade. And I will see you guys in the next one. Thank you, and I'll see you guys later.